Al, which tent is yours?
Sold it, they took. Right now, they're I'm calling the lawyer. Fuck all that. Y'all won't even let me fucking in there. Get my own property. All right. And now you're telling me.
Would you like this?
Now you're telling me different. So like which one is it?
We cannot verify to whom it belongs. So because.
So you can tell
you
me it's not my
like
spot.
Or would you like to keep interrupting?
Do you hear yourself right now?
So. I know because you're talking over me.
You can't hear yourself?
Because you're talking over me.
Holy shit,
dude. May I explain? Because the city cannot verify to whom it belongs, you can come say, hey, this is my stuff. I've run into situations where someone says, hey, this is mine. A minute later, someone says, no, it's my stuff. So, because the city can't verify it, we have to be a part of it.
Who did y'all ask it? This guy was somebody's spot because I've been sitting here for 30 minutes
it was
asking you guys right here and nobody said shit to me.
It was unattended.
All right, Michael. I get that. I went to breakfast and I came back and y'all had already put all this up.
It was unattended. I wasn't over here, homie. The sidewalk must be happening.
All right, I get that. Y'all haven't let me in to push my stuff back or to straighten anything because you couldn't verify something that you never asked anybody about.
My phone is in my tent. It's a Nokia and I have a bunch of portable chargers.
Thank you.
brought a party set. I guess I'm not putting it in.
Thank you. No, but not everybody wants to see that.
Their shit, that'd be all hot and heavy if you saw. Stupid asses.
My shoes were clean.
Do like a film me later, but not like a
no,
just like a makeup thing. Like I stand in the cold.
Thank you.
comfortable if I take one step closer?
No, you gotta sit right in the line. Okay. You have to take one.
I understand. That's why I asked.
This is deprivation of rights under colour of law. They make it look like it's legal, but the cops are there. I can assure you it's 100% illegal.
Sanitation department and the cops and transportation and the
together. This is organized crime. I already have the FBI investigating this to enforce the recall law. This is organized. So it's like dealing with the mob. It's the exact same. This is the mob. This is the mob. Sanitation, they're the designated administrative authority for 8611. 5611, rather. They are the designated, they're responsible for the administration of 5611, which is LA Municipal Code. And they're also responsible for making sure that it's lawfully applied. They are violating their own responsibilities. They know they're doing it, they know that it's fraud. It's called constructive fraud. They know they're doing it. Constructive fraud. They're constructively defrauding. If you're not actively doing something about this, if you don't pick up the phone and call the FBI and the Attorney General and Internal Affairs and the Office of the Inspector General, if you don't pick up the phone and call these guys, you are enabling these people. You're allowing this to happen. You're allowing this to happen. But you will be on the list. This is all Agenda 21. Have you ever heard of Agenda 21? The agenda for the 21st century. I recommend you find out about it. Do you have any children? Me either. I have family that have children and they're not expected to live 5 years. Agenda 21 is genocide. This is all part of Agenda 21. Google it. You will see what I'm talking about.
You better not doing your fucking job. You're too busy staying around. Make sure that the homeowner's passive, they upside, is not trapped again because they keep the land and the ocean. And where's the trash please? I'm gonna go there and make sure my friend's dead body's not rotting. Because I sat in a fucking tub, bro. I sat in a fucking tub. This is no joke. This is...
The Los Angeles police, you just illegally removed me from the sidewalk. You gave me no notice. There's a new law out, 4118. I'm protesting from the sidewalk. I should have to go on the sidewalk because I need to be legal.
I'm going to talk to the police and the sanitation department. Right here. Let's go around so you can you see me okay? Can you see? Everybody can see me?
Yeah.
Get together more so I'm speaking directly. I'm going to start to address my house to the police. Can you see me?
Yeah.
Okay. So I'm officially announcing a demonstration on September 5th at noon. I spoke to Officer Kimmy Dixon yesterday, and she confirmed that I can have a demonstration here for sidewalksociety.world. This is a society I founded to establish rights, to give us a voice. And when I just came back, I heard the officers saying sidewalksociety.world. And I'm assuming that all of a sudden, out of nowhere, my tent was taken. You can film it. Just turn around so you can see where my tent was, please. You see it right there? It's right next to the Google building, right next to that tree. And there was never a problem. I've had a good when you're ready, turn back around. I've never had a problem with any police officer on the street. I've never had a problem with any sanitation person. I'm speaking right now, officer. Can you? Okay, now can you hear? Hello? Please give me the... Officer, you promised me to give me the information. I only come from the sidewalk since my ride is on the sidewalk. Yeah. Thank you. So what's your name, please, officer? I would like you to tell me your name, please. As soon as the noise of truth is on you, you're turning around like cowards. All you have is a monopoly of violence. I came back around 12:30. I was informed I could not take any of my stuff. But then, fortunately, they gave me 15 minutes. The sanitation department refused to give me a wicker basket that was right there on the sidewalk, even though it was right there. So this is not humane. Anyway, sorry, I'm a little bit nervous. I'm scared.
I didn't think it was gonna be this, that I was just gonna find myself without anything. So I organized a demonstration, and I believe that's the reason why I'm being removed here. On September 5th at noon on this street, I had the permission, Officer Dixon verbally confirmed, and she said I was gonna get back with her next week. I hope this is still standing. I have a feeling, I don't know what's happening now. Please film this. They're right now with a, they're destroying my house. You can film it right there as I'm speaking to you. This was my home for a year. And I built this. I'm not a destitute person, I'm an artist. I worked as an acting teacher. I lost a lot of my income. I was a van lifer because I wanted to save money so I can spend more time on my art. And my van is breaking down. And here we are. I have a PhD in psychology, and I live out here because I lost most of my income. I was a van lifer before, I decided that because my bus kept breaking down and we were given the opportunity to put up tents because of COVID, to use that, because my job is just up the street. And I was never an activist. I was just somebody who wanted to write my book that I wanted to finish, called From Harvard to Homeless to Happy, and do my acting teaching. And over the year, I saw what was happening on these streets. I saw people being abused, the police. Yeah, well, we all know about that, but I'm gonna get into more detail there later. And I can't believe I'm watching my stuff being torn up like that. Sorry, I'm a little bit nervous, I'm scared. And I'm gonna do my best to be articulate. And so I decided I wanted to start a movement to support people who are on the street to be able to actually have the right to be on the sidewalk. That's why I called it sidewalksociety.world. So they can get their bearings. And for people like me to not have to move 5 miles out of the way to then have to go to work, or really, I'm sorry, I'm just totally discombobulated, I apologize. If you want to read about the idea, it's www.sidewalksociety.world, and it's really rudimentary. The most important thing right now is that I applied and received permission to have a demonstration right on the street here in front of 320 Hampton, and I spoke to Officer Kimmy Dixon of the Permits Department, because I wanted to do it the right way. I wanted to do it in a legal way because I believed I have rights in this country. I'm a green card holder, so I'm legally here. And I come back just a day later to find my house being torn up. Now, one thing I want to say, I want to point out to you, do you see these things on the, you see these on the street here?
Yeah.
So, and you see it also on my bullhorn. You see it on the bullhorn?
Yeah.
So that is a symbol of the white rose. This is Sophie Scholl, German, you probably know about this, the white rose. She put up pamphlets against the Nazis and she was executed. So she stood up to power and, let me just put this down. And because she stood up to power, the Nazi regime executed her. And if you look at the closest street right here, it's Rose Avenue. So in honor of her, I named it Rose, and also have a tattoo on my left forearm here. So I'm gonna turn up the cross. So this is Sophie Scholl, this is the White Rose, the organization she's from. And she said, laws change, conscience doesn't. So on September 3rd, they wanna pass a new law that criminalizes homelessness. You can look it up, I don't wanna get into the details. So I put these tags everywhere to say that, give people the feeling that somebody is going to stand up for them, just like Sophie Scholl did, standing up for the Nazis. And just 2 days ago, out here on, I'm not exactly, I'm a little bit confabulated, on the corner of Rose and Hampton, I was detained by the police, and I asked why, and they said, because you're riding a bike without lights, and you're holding a spray can, and what are you doing? It's 4 o'clock in the morning, and I said, I'm spraying, I'm beautifying the sidewalk, I'm putting flowers on the sidewalk. And they said, well, they showed me the stencil, they saw the stencil, they also have the symbol on my phone, so they saw that I had it there, and they didn't apprehend me for defacing the sidewalks, they apprehended me for riding a bicycle without lights. And I asked them, I said, I'm not resisting any arrest. Why are you handcuffing me? And they're saying, well, we just want to make sure. And they didn't really have an answer to that. I had a conversation with them and then they said, well, we could have been more clear. They did acknowledge that they apprehended me. I'm sorry, I didn't know what to say. And they asked me, where are you going? What are you doing? And it was at the moment when I said, no, where do you live? And I didn't have the wherewithal, like, I was so like scared and confused because I've never actually,
I was arrested 20 years ago once and never went to trial and was thrown out. So I don't have this experience of being arrested by the police. So I said to them, I wish I could be a little more clear. I just got my house taken away from me, so I'm a little bit nervous. So they said to me, where do you live? So I said, well, yeah, I'm a homeless. This is my place down here. And it was almost like the moment they realized I wasn't going to have any power, when they felt okay to apprehend me. And they never charged me with doing that. And I actually even said to the officer, I said, well, if I do this, is that illegal? And he said, well, technically, yes, but nobody's going to say anything about it. So in no time ever did they say you're breaking the law, and that's why. They just apprehended me over. So anyway, so this was 2 days ago. Then the next day, I speak to Officer Dixon, because I was like, well, I don't want to do this like fly-by-night thing anymore. I'm going to do this right. Does it believe that? And now I'm hearing these officers right outside my tent as I'm scrambling to give me 15 minutes. They say sidewalk society. I heard him say it. So do I have proof that this is why they tore it up? No. But we got no notice, nothing at all. And all of a sudden, for some reason, if you look right here, if you look at the tent, this tent all the way up here, all the way here, and for some reason, they just start right at my tent. So to me, that's a little odd. Anyway, so this movement that I'm starting, if you see here, this is the two right here, because I decided, maybe in moments like this when I'm too nervous to talk, to just show what this is about. So this is Dr. Martin Luther King. And these are like the commandments of this movement. You see it's like the Ten Commandments. You see the tablets here? You see the tablets? So I'm gonna read this to you. Like I said, I'm too nervous to just say it out loud myself. So it says, I love you. I would rather die than hate you. Love is creative understanding for all. It is the refusal to deceive any individual, and that includes the police. As much as I have a hard time with them, it's not about them either. When you rise to the level of love, to its great beauty and power, you only want to defeat evil systems. The individuals that are caught up in that system, you love, but you seek to defeat the system. And I didn't know that I was going to be on a sidewalk. I'm sorry, this is my fucking home at this point. Anyway, so the name of this movement is, going to sidewalks, the symbol is the white rose. It's actually funny that I'm standing right next to the symbol that's put on the sidewalk here. And I believe laws can change, and that's what this demonstration is. That I hope they will not make illegal. They did say to me, you can have the demonstration on the sidewalk. And ironically, I said to the officer, sidewalks are all full. We can't do it on the sidewalk. But now they cleaned up the sidewalk for us. Look at it. We have space. I even looked it up online. You have a legal right to have demonstrations on the sidewalk. So at noon, and I'm going to be more coherent at that time, hopefully. You have all that space to have a conversation about this. And so this is Martin Luther King always said. And I'm not comparing myself to him. Obviously, he never